cool. Look, you're straight ahead.
How old are you?
11.
You're 8? And you saw 10? You're 11. Okay. Yeah, have you seen the movie?
Yeah.
How old were you when you watched 10? 5? Did you learn new words?
No, I got distracted.
All these bungalows are offices for producers and directors and writers. Mark Platt, producer for Play Wicked. He's got an office down the driveway on the left with an MP sign and a Wicked border. He's currently producing a movie version of Wicked for Universal. One of the most famous directors of all time, Alfred Hitchcock, the master of suspense, used to work out a bungalow of 5195. Hitchcock was a director known for cameos. Almost every time he directed a movie, he would pop up in a movie somewhere in a little scene, like what Stan Lee used to do in the Marvel films. This is what Hitchcock looked like in some of the films he directed for us. So let me tell you about the set over here on the left side of the tram. This is a part of a backlot called New York Street. And around the corner in New York Street today, they're working on Bel Air. But we can dress up this part of the backlot to be different cities, different states, different time periods. And a good example of using that part of a backlot for different time periods, we've been filming Quantum Leap out there. And if you're not familiar with the show, starting with a yellow coupe, which was used in American Graffiti, one of the first feature-length films written and directed by George Lucas, who directed Star Wars. This was before Star Wars. Harrison Ford is also an American Graffiti. He sings in the film. We've got cars from Back to the Future, Back to the Future Part 2. Picture cars don't need to work. They don't have to have engines. They just have to look like real cars when they're filming. The Flintstones cars don't have engines. Because the Flintstones don't have engines. They had to use their feet to get up to work, just like in the cartoon. We have a car from Harry Potter. We have some vehicles from the Jurassic Park and Jurassic World films, including a gyrosphere that was designed and built specifically for the fourth installment of the series, Jurassic World. We have a boat coming up, a crawdaddy. It was used in Jordan Peele's Us. And there's a scene in the movie where two characters who look exactly alike are having a fight on the boat. And a couple of military vehicles that were used in the first Transformers, which it filmed scenes on New York Street that we just passed by. Now we're coming up to the first quiet zone on the tour. I'm going to turn off the sound maybe for about 3 or 4 minutes for the filming of Quantum Leap. This stars Raymond Lee, Caitlin Bassett, and they're filming in our old Mexico town and our old Western town. So even though I'm going to have the sound turned off, I'll play some videos up on the monitors that correspond to some of the sets that we're going to be passing by. So I'll talk to you again as soon as they say it's okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you for your patience, everybody. There is going to be another quiet zone again. We're going to be passing by that area. But the next quiet zone only gets past for about 2 minutes. At this point, we are a little bit past the halfway mark. Pause this for a second. This is a scene from the very first episode of the show. They're at Yogurt. That set is right in front of me. It's the set with the two blue doors and the red trim. It's where they filmed this scene.
I can't risk going to a bad place.
Maybe it's not all that bad. What is the bad place?
Doesn't sound awesome.
These are all the compulsive sets from our classic black and white horror movies made in the 1930s and 1940s. This is the Village of Frankenstein, Dracula, the Wolfman, the Invisible Man. Those movies would almost always have a scene with a big mob of angry villains.
Is it done?
Yeah, we're about the Wolfman.
That's him.
You alright?
They were shooting that scene at night. They waited for all the tours to finish for the day before they started bringing it out.
Sit down to talk about the war in the world. I thought, what if the 747 goes down right in a big neighborhood? Because it's just something you don't see.
You're doing good. You're looking good. You're impressing me. Listen now, man. Listen, I want you to close your eyes, okay? Sit down close.
Bobby, get in.
Shot that plane down. Universal released a film in theaters this summer that also involved the UFO. Nope. Now we're going to be driving through the set of Jupiter's Claim. It was a set
of a nostalgic, small-time Southern California amusement park owned by former child star Ricky G. Park. Over there, welcome to the Winking Room. And have your picture taken just like the kids in that old 90s movie kid show. That's what this whole place is loosely based on. Remember that? No? Wow. Well, you can see the brand new Star Wars. your eyes. Built to showcase an unbelievable new live show.
It's not looking so live.
Anyway, behind this Hollywood fantasy of all Russian artists lies a sinister secret. To the world.